I think it actually loads something, but as you can see, just loading the operating system right there. I should go somewhere here, for example, the startup disk. I can just basically do whatever I want with the system, right? Hey guys, and welcome to a new episode of Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're going to talk again about iMac G4 and classic macOS 9 and also macOS 10 Tiger. I think those are really representative operating system of their era. I really think that there are multiple things that those operating systems did better than the current versions of macOS. Why? Well, let's discuss why. So, the first reason why, I really like the UI, for example, in macOS 9. Take a look at the size of the windows. Like, it's really small, functional enough, just to, like, it gives you enough information to be able to operate your operating system. Of course, not everything was ideal in macOS 9, but many areas of the operating system design was quite nice. I mean, just take a look at everything, it just like feels really fluid. By the way, you can still browse the web on macOS 9, and for that reason, you're gonna use a browser called Classila, which is basically like a port of Mozilla Firefox on the macOS 9 platform. Well, it doesn't work that great, it kinda works, you know. It's loading everything really slow, but come on, load at least something. It was loading something before. Alright, yeah, at least it loaded something. So how it works basically, it just tells the web pages that it's a mobile UI and it just like load me the mobile version of the website. For example, YouTube, if you go to youtube.com, I think it actually loads something, but security warning, yeah. So that's how it works, and it's really, really slow. I mean, because it's a G4, it's basically 2003 or 2004 module, so you can expect that. But what I like about macOS 9 is this like ability to minimize application is quite nice. I mean, not to minimize, but to minimize the main area of the application. And this one, I mean, this is just lovely way of controlling everything. But there are some stuff, of course, I don't like. For example, here, when I open this window, it just doesn't say like system settings anywhere here. I need to go to control panels. And then, for example, I should go somewhere here. For example, the startup disk. Startup disk allows me to select which disk I'm gonna be loading. And because there are macOS 10 Tiger and then macOS 9, I can just basically select which system I want to boot, which is quite neat. And then what else here? The appearance. I actually was discussing this in one of my previous videos about macOS 9, but this video I'm doing like 2 years later on the same computer. It feels still nice to be able to use this, and especially with the internet connection. I think it didn't even load it, this one. And you guys can see that when you open something here, I think everything stucks. Yeah, I mean, when you start loading any website here, it just stucks. I mean, the whole, okay, sometimes it doesn't stack, sometimes it stacks, and can just hand the whole system. This is how the operating system back in the day were working like that. So like, it's really, really tough to load anything. I also like that WinAmp was available for the macOS 9. I can just like play my favorite MP3 files. Of course, the QuickTime Player version was available. You can still use it for some specific tasks. I also have Microsoft Word installed here, and you can just like open some document, type something here. You can still use it for simple tasks like that. Really, really useful. And there's still the community of people who actually use the macOS 9, and I personally think it's a good system, but there was some flaws in the design of the system itself. That's why it was replaced by macOS 10. The main flaw is multitasking. Multitasking was definitely not that great. It was really, really bad. Like hanging off up one application completely drags the whole system down. But on G4, this macOS 9 system runs really, really good. So now let's switch to macOS 10. And to do that, we actually need to go back to startup disk and we need to select macOS here and then press restart. So, what I like about macOS Tiger? I think that macOS Tiger is like Windows XP in the PC world. What I especially like about macOS 10 Tiger is the fact that all the animation, all the applications and like the menus and stuff like that was really, really simple. It just served the purpose, right? For example, I open the spotlight right here and it just like opens right there and nowhere else. It's just in a specific area of the UI. I really like it. I don't like it in the modern versions of macOS because it's like, it just floating through the whole UI. It's like really simple, just like you know where the location of this one. It's really nice. So on macOS Tiger, you can just browse the web just fine. There's application called 10.4.fox, and you can download the specific browser for your platform. So in my case, it's PowerPC 7450. I think it's a specific version of G4 processor, and you can browse the web, but again, it's super, super slow. But I think at least it's loading YouTube. It just like, at least it attempts to load loaded compared to macOS 9, which just hangs completely. Alright guys, so it's actually loading YouTube, but I'm not gonna wait like half an hour until it finishes, so sorry, I'm gonna close it because this is super slow. Also, what I like about the macOS 10 is the ability to run macOS 9 apps here in emulation. And here, when you install the classic environment, you are able to start your applications from macOS 9 like this. So you press here, press start classic, it's gonna load an instance of macOS 9 right here. As you can see, just loading the operating system right there. Alright, so once it loaded, it actually has two icons right here, the simple text and the script editor. When you press on the simple text, it just opens like a text editor of macOS 9. And here, by the way, you can see the menu of macOS 9. It's just like they put it on top of macOS 10 menu. Basically, when you open those applications, it just like shows like that. And you can see like all the context windows of the menus of the macOS 9. Really good kind of integration, because when you switch to like, let's say, Finder, it goes back to the macOS 10 kind of menus. I think this is what a macOS 10 Tiger got really well, so it's able to run PowerPC apps for macOS 10 and also macOS 9 apps. And for example, I can just like open my macOS disk, open the applications folder of macOS 9, and let's say I want to open some utility, let's say Sherlock 2. Stop launching Sherlock, this version of Sherlock not optimized. Yeah, continue. For example, if I just really want, because I know there's a Sherlock for macOS 10 as well, and it launches just fine with all the menus of macOS 9. It just like runs completely fine, but as you can see, the icons are not optimized for the macOS 10. Those look really pixelated. And for example, you can also run WinAmp from the macOS 9 like this. So it starts just fine. You can just like use WinAmp version. Which version is that? Yeah, it was development build, something like that. So all right. And just to stop the macOS classic environment, you just press stop classic. And that's it. That's how compatible macOS 10 Tiger was and how stable it for the most part. I really liked it. I especially liked the simplicity of macOS Tiger because it was like really simple, really open, and there was not much additional junk. For example, if you go to the system preferences, then you open security. There was no like gatekeeper stuff like that, no ability just to stop you from installing any apps you want. Like, I do really like this, like when operating system tells me what I want to install, what I don't. So the gatekeeper, in my opinion, it's not really necessary. Like, it was the app just like blocking me from installing anything I want. I don't want my operating system to tell me what I can install or not. And I really like the design of the old disk utility because it has all the options that you need. It has much more advanced options like a new image burn. It's additional stuff integrated right there. And I think it's really cool. Later on, the disk utility for Mac was really stripped down. They have removed a bunch of features and it looked not that good. Also, another thing that I really liked about the old Macs is the ability to run the single user mode. Let me actually show you what is that. So single user mode is when you press Command and S during the boot up process of your system to be able to just go straight to the command line instead of the graphical interface. So let's see. I'm a root user and I'm able to do anything I want with the system. And I can see my partitions, I can do stuff. I can just basically do whatever I want with the system, right? And I can run, for example, some specific applications, console applications here, and for example, Midnight Commander, but it's not installed here. In modern versions of macOS, I need to go to the system recovery. So basically the system became very locked down kind of to the specific hardware, to the specific user and all that. It's just like, I feel like in the recent version of macOS, it all became like about the graphical stuff, about how beautiful the icon is, about the transitions. I'm not really that kind of person. I prefer the functionality over those kind of nice UI and that stuff. So that's how it is, guys. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and hit the like button. There will be more videos about the classic macOS and the macOS 10. We're gonna discuss basically all this kind of stuff. In terms of the new transition to the ARM platform, I think it's really interesting to go back, discover all the stuff that the previous versions of macOS had. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.